relatively close, but still considered pretty far, far away, there was an evil intergalactic fortress owned by the Jerry Corporation, also known as Jerry Co. This evil organization has a fortress built with a gigantic space cannon and an impenetrable, electromagnetic wall. They also happen to mass produce counterfeit space weapons such as lightsabers, blasters, and Darth Vader masks. But a group of seven heroic Jedi priests attempted to overtake this evil corporation. First, they tried using force. Then they tried knocking.
Pizza!
Then they tried some sneaky sneaking. After numerous attempts and it almost working, a mysterious man appeared.
Where are we going?
I am Darth Vader. How can I get to the city?
See, I have already delivered Jerry Co. into your hands, along with its CEO and its employees. March around the fortress once every day for 6 days. Have your Jedi priests carry sonic noise blasters in front of the Ark. On the seventh day, march around the fortress 7 times with the priests firing their sonic noise blasters. When you hear a long blast, have the whole army give a shout. The walls will collapse and the army will go straight in.
All right, man. Here's the plan. We're gonna go around the city once every day for 6 days. On the seventh day, we're gonna go around trumpet tooting. And then, after we go around the city 7 times on the seventh day, there's gonna be a loud blast, and then we're all gonna yell, and then the city of Jericho will fall, and it will be ours.
All right, sounds good?
Day one. Day two.
Oh my.
Day three.
I thought you guys knew it.
I like your seat out camera.
Day four.
Gonna try at all? You're not fighting us?
Day 2 plus 3. Day 6.
Are you getting dizzy yet?
Finally, day 7.
We gotta go.
Dude, I'm about to start.
We definitely ran like 8 times.
All right, let's get it up one more time.
All right, so what we got was the story of Joseph, and we're going to do it in the K-drama style. Ooh. All right, so it was Jaewon and his 7 brothers, or 8 brothers and sisters, and they were very rich.
Oh, Jaewon, my favorite son. You're such a good studious student. You're going to go to a great high school and great college and have some great life. Here, I want you to have this.
Oh, cousin.
Is that Gucci? 24 karat gold is infused in this, so please take care of it. Now, go run off to your brothers. Have fun.
Now the brothers were very jealous. Brothers and sisters were very jealous. And because of that, they were plotting their revenge.
What about boarding school?
So basically they went and grabbed her and took her jacket off and used her jacket to pay for boarding school. Now in boarding school, she was a model student.
Ah, you are definitely the best student I've ever seen here. I'm going to make you the student class council.
And because she was a model student, he was also very handsome. Because he pushed a girl, he went into detention. However, in detention, he was also a very model student.
Wait, actually, oh my, this dream. Wait, who are you? Wait, can you introduce the dream to me? Okay, so, the Wonder Girls. Sang three songs, what does it mean?
It means that in 3 days, they're gonna reunite and get back together.
All right. Big Bang, they were performing 7 songs, right? And they fell down, and they all got put in a coma, right? All know what that means.
It means that in like 7 months, they're all gonna die.
Now the principal also had a dream.
I had a really, really weird dream a few days ago. Do you know anybody who's gonna interpret them?
Hey.
Oh, okay. Hi. Yeah. I thought I had a really weird dream where there were 7 report cards on the page and another set of 7 report cards that all had passed. Do you know what that means?
It means that for 7 years, the school is gonna have a lot of funding, and then there's gonna be 7 years and the whole school is gonna go bankrupt. You should probably start saving up.
And all that came true. And because of that, her brothers came back to her. Brothers and sister came back to her during the second
week.
This is the story of Deborah and Barack, translated into modern times.
Scene 1. We're currently in the White House with cabinet members Barack Obama, wave, Michelle Obama, wave, and Vladimir Putin, wave, and he's oppressing them for oil.
More oil! All the oil! My best friend, get me the oil! More oil! Oil! Oil!
Scene 2. We are now
in the White House.
We are now in the White House. Barack Obama goes to his significant other, Michelle Obama, for help.
Please help me.
We lost. Hashtag not my president.
Please.
Fine, I'll help you, Barack.
Scene
Come, my henchman. There's so many. We're never.
Oh, mother, I'm back.
Why?
They're staring at all my men are dead!
Vladimir Putin escaped. The Tenyaman all died. Scene 4. He flees to his allies in China.
The Americans will never find me.
Let me in front of your ally.
Sure. Come in, ally.
Come in.
Do you have any oil?
Here, have some milk. You must be tired.
I am. Oh, so nervous. Thank you. Oh.
Sleep well. Sleep
thank
well.
You.
She covers him with a cloth. The American can't find her.
I'm actually a double agent.
Takes the humor and drives into his head. Thus, America wins.
Alright, now say it.
Alright, our story is Jesus' parables, so we have three different parables that we are performing. We have the parable of the prodigal son, and then the parable of the good Samaritan, and finally the parable of the unmerciful servant. And our theme was a silent film.
I'm sorry.
done as a comedy.
Ooh.
Scene one, Rebecca is giving birth.
Oh my goodness, these babies are fighting in my belly.
I'm gonna be first.
No, no, no.
Jacob, stop watching your brother.
Ha ha ha. Oh no.
Boy, long day of hunting. I'm famished.
Hello, famished. I'm Jacob.
Yeah.
Well, well, you have to give me your birthright, though.
Fine.
You bitch!
What? I'm just a water boy!
The voice is eliminating the fall of the lion, the fall of the bear, the snake, and the cannon.
Okay, okay, well, if you want, you gotta try these limited edition jewelry.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You're fine.
Okay,
see,
okay.
I got these Jesus.
They make a water boy as an Israelite. It's their last hope. Dribbles up the court. Cross the goal! Yeah! Well, anyone from the Philistines found the Israelites.
Is this water boy?
The Israelites win!
Downstairs, I want to show you to all my friends. You are a trophy wife. You're nothing but a pretty face to me. I have a little dignity. I'm not a pretty face. Waste of space. I'm staying here. One, two.
So Vashti refused, and Xerxes and his advisors decided to depose her because she posed a threat as a rebellious wife and threatened the very structure of marriage in Persia. See you. So Xerxes is single now. Woo! And so he's to find him a hot new wife, a hot new queen. And so they looked through the entire land of Persia for a new queen. Mordecai decided to volunteer his beautiful cousin Esther, and she was crowned queen.
Come here.
Oh, I can't wait to be king.
She kept her religion a secret. Secret. So, one day, Mordecai, the guy who volunteered Esther, was standing guard at the palace, and he heard two guys plotting to assassin Xerxes.
Kill him now, kill him now, we're going to kill the king. Kill him now, kill him now, I hope no one's listening.
Mordecai overheard and warned the king, and they saved the king's life. Now, Haman, Mordecai's second in command, was walking through the city, and he wanted everyone to bow to him. He was so cool. Look at his dashing look. So he's walking through the city, and he sees Mordecai, the Jew. And Mordecai refuses to bow to him because
came in just so cool. So he was like, give this guy your horse, the king's horse, and your robe, the king's robe, and let him ride through the city.
I would give him so many things. A fancy robe or some diamond rings.
Put him on top of one of those. Oh, what's that word again?
A horse. Parade him around. Give him a day. Let people know that he is your fave. He is the best. Up of the rest. Up on that horse.
Haman, you're the genius. We're gonna give that to Mordecai. Haman's like, what?
You should. Yeah, that's important. Oh.
Let's get down to business to defeat that Jew. Mordecai won't bow down, and I see revenge.
Xerxes agreed and signed a decree that one day, on a day later in the year, all the Jews will be killed or attacked. Haman built a 70-foot tall gallows to hang Mordecai. Mordecai found out, and he was really sad. So he started mourning and wore sackcloth and showered himself in ashes.
Haman's going to kill Esther. Esther, won't you sing a song? Talk to Xerxes, your move.
I'm pretty sure that was.
So Mordecai told Esther everything that was going to happen, and Esther promised to save the Jews. She started praying to hear what God would tell her to help save her people. So Esther went to go see the king. But if she went without being summoned. So if the king wanted to kill her, he could. But she didn't die. Xerxes wanted to see her and raised his staff. So Xerxes asked, what do you want, my queen? I will give you up to half my kingdom. And Esther said, I'm going to have a dinner party. I want you and Haman to be there.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our family chicken breast. Be our Haman here, we'll have an ice cold root beer. Be our guest, be our guest, you're the best.
So Esther, Haman, and the king had a grand old dinner party with chicken breast and root beer. At the first dinner party, the king was like, so my wife, what do you want from me? Because you know you're buttering me up. And she said, come to another dinner party. So then they had another dinner party, and Haman was feeling really good about himself because he went to do two dinner parties with the royal family. So at the second dinner party, the king was like, okay, Esther, what do you want from me? And Esther was like, I want two things, that you'll save the Jews, my people, and you'll also kill Haman. Jesus. Haman is shocked and he threw himself on Esther, begging for forgiveness. But Xerxes thought Haman was attacking Esther and condemned him to die.
I can feel that news tonight. It feels so tight. The lever of the Lord falls from under me.